right. I'm Andrew again. I'm here with Troy Hewitt, and we're talking to them about Pirates of the Burning Sea. It's a pirate-based MMO that's coming out later this year in June. So, Troy, what can you tell me about Pirates?
So, Pirates of the Burning Sea is a massively multiplayer online game set in the Age of Sail. So, we are sailing around in the 1720s Caribbean. You can be pirate, British, French, or Spanish. Those nationalities have all kinds of economical and political strife, and that you as a player get to travel that world and sort of participate in that storyline.
Now, what made you guys decide to do pirates? Because MMOs typically, you know, they're fantasy, they're like the World of Warcrafts. Yeah, they've just gotten into superheroes with City of Heroes, and people are actually still trying to do sci-fi right. Sci-fi hasn't even been done perfectly yet in most MMOs, but pirates, it's a big thing to do. It's totally different.
Absolutely. So we've been in development for almost 5 years now. So we were doing pirates before pirates became really cool. We love what Disney's done with the movie, and they've really helped us out quite a bit with our cause. And the reason why we went with pirates is exactly the reason. You look at the MMO space, and there are lots of fantasy games. They haven't quite got science fiction done right. My last gig was working with The Matrix Online, and so it was a challenge.
I played The Matrix Online. It started really well, had a lot of cool things going on, a lot of live events.
That's what I did.
And devs and stuff like that. And then it just kind of petered off.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and so we decided to go a different route. There are lots of great games out there, lots of great companies. They're working hard to produce a great product. And you know, and WoW clearly is devastating. I mean, it's, you know, lots of people, 7 million people are playing WoW. So. Yeah. So there's definitely room for fantasy, but we decided to go in a different direction, to kind of take a more historical... That isn't to say that there aren't some fantasy aspects to Pirates of the Burning Sea, but ultimately it is a historical game with beautiful scenery and ships and avatar combat, which swashbuckling combat. So while we kind of went a different route with the genre, it still has some fantasy elements.
So best part about the game, it's like, 'cause, you know, most games, you have to do a lot of crafting, you got to make your own equipment, you have to, you know, go on quests to search for things. Figuring with a Pirates game, you're going to want to have your own ship, you're going to want to sail. Can you have your own crew?
You actually can have your own crew. You actually start off with a ship, so you're never without a ship in our game. But as you gain more experience, you gain access to bigger and better ships. So that's kind of the way we've designed it. There's also avatar combat, which allows you to kind of gain more experience as a fencer or a dual sword wielder. There are lots of different options as far as avatar combat goes. You know, the best part of the game, my particular favorite, is ship-to-ship combat. It's really, really enjoyable.
I'm seeing some of it on the video right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Cool. Yeah, so this is actually our newest video. And you're seeing, this is some footage. This is actual footage from the game, not rendered. We've got, this is actually footage taken by some of our folks. Our beta testers participated in this video. So we kind of put, this is our, we call it our lost scene coming up here. But, you know, all kinds of avatar spaces, social spaces for people to hang out. And this is the lost scene right here, running through the jungle.
So you got land combat, you have sea combat.
Absolutely. We have a really robust economy. It's a completely player-driven economy. So players craft and build their own ships and everything. As pirates, you can actually capture other ships. The Spanish, the British, and the French, when they capture a ship, they get a certificate of strength or a certificate of endurance. And those are things that they can actually turn in for, as they gather them, they can actually turn them in for special items, special rigging, special unique items for their ship or their avatar.
And is it like a completely PvP game, or is it player versus enemy?
Can you choose? Of that. You can choose. So you can actually. So we've got a pretty robust port versus port system, and what it does is that you can, as the French, I can decide if you're English, I can gang up on you with my buddies and start picking on you and throw your port into contention. And so what happens is the French then take over that particular port, and there is a giant battle to determine who actually owns it, and that's a 25 versus 25 ship battle. So these people battle it out, and whoever wins gains the economic and political supremacy of that particular port. And it creates a PvP zone that grows and changes as the battle sort of progresses. That can be, you can have three or four ports in a row that are in contention, and so it creates, and you can see on your map, this zone, this red zone, that sort of an area that if you're not particularly fond of PvP, you can avoid.
That's very cool. Well, it sounds like a really cool game. The only thing I'm really wondering is, how is the create a character? When you create your character, how like robust is it?
So actually, we are. It was really important to us to have a pretty robust character creation system, and we took a page from City of Heroes. They've got an excellent character creation system, and some of the things that we offer are like them, but some of the things we offer are clearly distinct to Pirates of the Burning Sea. So we have a very, very robust character creation system.
Because that was always my one pet peeve, kind of, about WoW. It's like, as much as the game has, as deep as it is, everybody has the same armor. Everybody has the same clothes. And even if you find, like, the coolest armor in the world, you're always going to bump into someone eventually who has it just like you. You can't change the color or otherwise.
So given all of our selections related to clothing and other accoutrements, you can actually have trillions and trillions of combinations.
Very
so,
cool.
Yeah. So you can be very, very customized and very unique. And that was important to us.
Sounds like a cool game, and it's coming out in June. So hopefully it works out well, and you guys get a whole bunch of subscribers.
Yeah. All right. Thanks a lot for stopping by.
No problem.
Take care.